more than the police, the Ontario Police or the Mounted Police. And they have no accountability, and nobody they have to, even the politicians can't touch them, Auditor General can't even look at their books. Even their documentation on how they train their agents, they would not release to the court. And I just talked to Terry Green yesterday, and he said, no, on Friday, sorry, and he said, we got some good news. Curtis applied to have the manuals released to the court case. He's now, he's suing them, by the way. One of his clients is suing them for abuse. And Curtis asked for their agenda and all their training manuals, and they refused to give them to the court, but the court has now come down and said, you must hand them over. So we expect they will drop the case rather than hand the manuals over, or be looking for some kind of a plea bargain deal. That'll be in the next couple of weeks, we should find that out. But if not, we have had OSPCA, former OSPCA officers tell us some of the facts that are in these training manuals, and if we get a hold of them, they will be out in the public, we can assure you that. We have to get them in court first. So I don't want to go over my time limit, so I will stumble on. Any questions, anybody? I could do that for 2 minutes, probably. Just give money to me, Liz. Shirley Dolan has some forms here. If anybody has any extra change lying around, they would be lucky to have that to drive this thing. We'll end up in Supreme Court before this is over, because they will not take it lying down. They will appeal, and we will have to go ahead. So it costs us quite a bit of money. Okay, go ahead. Well, and I don't see anything wrong with that idea, other than manpower. You know, it takes a lot of effort to get all this stuff coordinated and get doing proper text. But anything that we have is open to anybody who wants it. Anybody needs that from us, we can definitely throw it out there. Our problem is lawyers, in a lot of ways. They would rather do real estate and wills. You know, there's a lot more money in that than it is challenging something as tough as a government. And so not too many of them will take on these challenges, because they're a headbanger, you know, you're up against a brick wall.
Well, I was also thinking, part of my reason is that if they already can draw on past victories, they might be more inclined to take it, going, well, hey, I've got 6 or 7 victories right here now, and this is all recent. So we might be able to get more lawyers.
Well, and I agree with you. And I would hope, I still live in hope, that I hope that some of the young lawyers coming out of school will not be as badly indoctrinated. You know, some of the old guys they've been brainwashed for so long they can't see past what they've been told. You know, and I would hope that we get a couple of young bucks that would like to change the world. You know, and not change the world, but keep the world free, you know, our world free. That's absolutely true, and the socialism trend that's happening in this country, and it's been on the march for a long time, and it's easy to see why it happens, because we are the problem. People are the problem, because we don't want to face our accusers, you might want to say. Like, my neighbor, you know, has let his dog crap on my doorstep, you know. I should go over and address my neighbor. Instead, they want to get the city or the municipality to make a bylaw So I don't have to face my neighbor and have to talk to them. So they want my, the municipality to be the big stick. And every time you do that little quest for more power and more laws, you take, you make it more social, socialistic. So it's a long road we've come down since the late 60s. I'd say the big slide started then, and we're going to have to push a long way uphill to get back even. The amount of, as Liz said, the amount of legislation and the fact that politicians don't read it before they vote for it.
Lawyers don't read it,
judges don't read it, lawyers don't read it. But you can't read it, you can't read it all. So, you know, seriously, you never get it all read. But, so you can't blame it on all the politicians. Our system is built on getting elected again. And, you know, from the day they win, they're back into the circus of trying to get votes for the next time. So. They don't like to vote on something that will lose votes. Anyways, I've babbled enough. I'll let Nick take it over.